Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. This is module number 2, First Law of Thermodynamics, and lecture number 204. We recap from the previous lectures. So, in the previous lectures, we derived the steady flow energy equation. And we applied the steady flow energy equation to different devices like nozzle, diffuser, turbine, compressor, pump and heat exchanger. And in this lecture, we will solve problem on the steady flow energy equation. This is part 2. Already in 203, we solved a few problems. We solved few additional problems on the application of steady flow energy equation. The learning outcome for the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem on the steady flow energy equation. And this is the general form of the steady flow energy equation. The left hand side, the terms on the left hand side are energy into the system, and terms on the right hand side is energy leaving the system. The steady flow energy equation is obtained by applying energy balance to a thermodynamic system. So, in the equation, m equal to the mass flow rate of the fluid at inlet and the outlet, v1, v2 are the velocity of the fluid at inlet and the outlet in meters per second, h1 and h2, they are the specific enthalpy at inlet and the outlet in joules per kilogram, z1, z2, they are elevation above the datum line at inlet and the outlet in meter, and Q is the amount of heat supply or heat transfer in joules per second, and W is the work transfer in joules per second. So, we have to substitute all the parameter in appropriate unit. That is very important in solving the problem. And this is example number 6 from the Anna University question paper, May 2019. The power output of an adiabatic steam turbine is 5 megawatt, and the state of the steam entering the turbine is pressure 2 megapascal, temperature 400 degrees Celsius, velocity 50 meters per second, and elevation is 10 meters. The state of steam leaving the turbine is pressure 15 kilopascal, dryness fraction 0.9, velocity 180 meters per second, and elevation 6 meters. Determine 1. The change in enthalpy, kinetic energy and potential energy. 2. The work done per unit mass of the steam flowing through the turbine. And 3. Mass flow rate of the steam. And after reading the problem, you write down the given data. So, the power is 5 megawatt. Pressure at the inlet 2 megapascal, which is 20 bar. T1 temperature is 400 degrees Celsius. Velocity at the inlet 50 meters per second. Z1 elevation 10 meters, at the outlet P3 equal to 15 kilopascal, which is 0.15 bar, dryness fraction of the steam is 0.9, velocity is 180 meters per second, and Z2 elevation is 6 meters. Now, this is a steam turbine. We have to use the steam table to take the properties, to take the specific enthalpy of the steam. At inlet condition, so P1 equal to 20 bar and T1 equal to 400 degrees Celsius. The specific enthalpy of superheated steam, H1 equal to 3248.7 kilojoules per kilogram. At the P2 equal to 0.15 bar for saturated steam, we take HF2 is 226 kilojoules per kilogram, and HFG2, that is sensible heat of water, latent heat of evaporation, 2373.2 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the enthalpy H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. Which is 226 plus 0.9 into 2373.2 equal to 2361.88 kilojoules per kilogram. So, we calculated H1 and H2 here. And the change in enthalpy, H2 minus H1 equal to 2361.88 minus 3248.7 equal to minus 886.82 kilojoules per kilogram. Change in enthalpy. And change in potential energy, G into Z2 minus Z1, 9.8 into 6 minus 10 equal to minus 39.24 joules per kilogram, or minus of 0.039.24 kilojoules per kilogram. and change in kinetic energy v2 square minus v1 square by 2 equal to 180 square minus 50 square divided by 2, which is 14,950 joules per kilogram or 14.95 kilojoules per kilogram. And work done per kg of the adiabatic steam, so W equal to, so this is again from the steady flow energy equation, rearranging the term, deleting Q for adiabatic steam turbine, W equal to G into Z1 minus Z2 plus V plus V1 square minus V2 square by 2 plus H1 minus H2, and the entire term you take negatives and outside, so this becomes G into Z2 minus Z1 plus V2 square minus V1 square by 2 plus H2 minus H1. So substituting all the values here and calculating W equal to 871.9 kilojoules per kilogram. The work done per kg of the steam of adiabatic steam turbine is 871.9 kilojoules per kilogram. And the mass flow rate now, M equal to power produced by the turbine divided by the work done. So 5000 divided by 871.8 equal to 5.73 kilograms per second. And the answer to the problem, the change in enthalpy minus 886.82 kilojoules per kilogram, the change in kinetic energy 14.95 kilojoules per kilogram, the change in potential energy minus of 0.03924 kilojoules per kilogram, and the work done per kg of the steam 871.9 kilojoules per kilogram, and the mass flow rate is 5.73 kilograms per second. Now we take the example number 7. In a gas turbine, the gases enters the turbine at a rate of 5 kilograms per second with a velocity of 50 meters per second and enthalpy 900 kilojoules per kilogram, and leaves the turbine at 150 meters per second with an enthalpy of 400 kilojoules per kilogram. The loss of heat from the gas to the surrounding is 25 kilojoules per kilogram. Assume R equal to gas constant R equal to 0.285 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, Cp equal to 1.004 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and inlet condition are to be 100 kilopascal and 27 degree Celsius. Determine work done and diameter of the inlet pipe. So write down the given data. M equal to 5 kilograms per second, velocity V1 equal to 50 meters per second, H1 equal to 900 kilojoules per kilogram, velocity at the outlet is 150 meters per second, enthalpy is 400 kilojoules per kilogram. Heat transfer Q equal to minus, so it is leaving the system, so minus of 25 kilojoules per kilogram, R equal to 0.285 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and P1 equal to 100 kilopascal, T1 equal to 27 degree Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. First we calculate the specific volume of the gas at the inlet, so V1 equal to RT1 divided by P1, which is 0.285 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.855 meter cube per kilogram. And diameter of the inlet pipe D1 equal to square root of 4 by pi, that is area. We have to calculate the area. From the area, we calculate the diameter. So, square root of 4 by pi into M into specific volume divided by the velocity at the inlet. So, 4 by pi into 5 into 0.855 divided by 50 equal to 0.33 meter. Diameter of the inlet pipe is 0.33 meter. And we write the steady flow energy equation per unit mass. So, simplifying the equation, work done equal to W into, so the Z value, it is not given, we can drop the Z value. So, V1 square minus V2 square by 2 plus H1 minus H2 plus Q. So, substituting 50 square minus 150 square divided by 2 plus 900 minus 400 into 1000 minus 25,000 equal to 46,000 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the work done per kg of the gas. And power of the turbine, M into W, so 5 into 465 equal to 2325 kilowatt, that is the power produced by the turbine. So, the answer to the problem, power output of the turbine is 2325 kilowatts and diameter of the inlet pipe is 0.33 meter. And the steady flow energy equation, generally for all the problem, so you write down the general steady flow energy equation and simplify based on the data given. Then it will be easy for you to solve the problem. And example number 8, the steam flows through a small turbine at the rate of 500 kilogram per hour, entering at 15 bar 300 degrees Celsius and leaving at 0.1 bar with a 4% moisture. The steam enters at 80 meters per second at a 0.2 meter above the discharge and leaves at 40 meters per second. compute the shaft power, assuming that the device is adiabatic, but the considering kinetic energy and potential energy changes. Calculate the inlet and the discharge tube areas. So, the given data, read the problem, write down the given data, mass equal to 500 kilogram per hour, which is 0.14 kilograms per second, inlet pressure is 15 bar, temperature is 300 degrees Celsius, outlet pressure is 0.1 bar, moisture of the steam is 4%, and velocity at the inlet is 80 meters per second, Z1 minus Z2 equal to 2 meter, and velocity at the outlet is 40 meters per second. So, from the steam table, at the pressure P1 equal to 0.1 bar, temperature T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius, using the superheated steam table, H1 enthalpy of the superheated steam 3038.9 kilojoules per kilogram, and specific volume of the superheated steam 0.1697 meter cube per kilogram. At the pressure P2 equal to 0.1 bar, HF2 equal to 191.8 and HFG2 equal to 2392.9. And VG2 equal to 14.65 meter cube per kilogram. The drainage fraction of the steam. So, the moisture is given as 4%. So, the drainage fraction is 1 minus the percentage of moisture. 1 minus 0.04 equal to 0.96. And we calculate the enthalpy. Enthalpy H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 HFG2, which is 191.8 plus 0.96 into 2392.9. equal to 2488.98 kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific volume at the outlet X2 into VG2, which is 0.96 into 14.65 equal to 14.064 meter cube per kilogram. Then we write the power output equation for the turbine from the steady flow energy equation, rearranging the term W equal to M into G into Z1 minus Z2 plus V1 square minus V2 square by 2 plus H1 minus H2, substituting all the values, M equal to 0.14 kilojoules per second, G 9.81, Z1 minus Z2 equal to 2, velocity 80 square minus 40 square divided by 2, H1 minus H2, 3038.9 minus 2488.98 into 1000. So, the W work done, or the power output of the turbine, is 390.9 kilowatts. Area of the inlet and outlet of the pipe, A1 equal to mass into, from the continuity equation, A1 equal to M into V1 divided by capital V1. Small V1 is the specific volume at the inlet, capital V1 is the velocity at the inlet. So, substituting the values, this is 2.97 into 10 power minus 4 meter square. Area at the outlet, again using the continuity equation, small V2 divided by capital V2. So, specific volume at the outlet, small V2, velocity at the outlet, capital V2, substituting the values and calculating, this is 0.049 meter square. And the answer to the problem, power output of the turbine 390.9 kilowatts, area of inlet pipe 2.97 10 power minus 4 meter square, area of the outlet pipe 0.049 meter square. We take example number 9 from the anionistic question paper, November 2017. Steam initially at 1.5 megapascal 300 degrees Celsius expands reversibly and adiabatically in a steam turbine to 40 degrees Celsius. Determine ideal work output of the turbine per kg of the steam. So, the given data, write down the given data. P1 equal to 1.5 megapascal equal to 15 bar, T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius and T2 equal to 40 degrees Celsius. So, from the steam table, at the P1 equal to 15 bar and 300 degrees Celsius, so, using the superheated steam table, enthalpy of the superheated vapor 3038.9 kilojoules per kilogram, and entropy of the superheated steam 6.921 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and T2 equal to 40 degrees Celsius, we take the HF2 value, HF2 equal to 167.5 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2408.9 kilojoules per kilogram, specific entropy of the liquid SF2 equal to 0.572 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 is 7.686 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Then for adiabatic expansion in the turbine, entropy is constant, S1 equal to S2. So, we take the equation, inlet entropy is known, S1 value, S2 it is assumed as wet steam. So, the entropy of the wet steam equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2, substituting all the values and calculating X2, x2 equal to 0.826, and the enthalpy of the steam at the outlet HF2 plus X2 into HFG2 equal to 167.5 plus 0.826 into 2406.9, which is 2155.6 kilojoules per kilogram. So, we have the enthalpy at the inlet, enthalpy at the outlet of the steam turbine. And from the steady flow energy equation, only the enthalpy value is given, other values are not given in the problem, including velocity and the datum, the Z1, Z2 value. So, W equal to H1 minus H2. This is 3028.9 minus 2155.6 equal to 883.3 kilojoules per kilogram, and this is the answer to the problem. Work output of the turbine is 883.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And we take the example number 10. A compressor delivers 720 kg of air per hour. Air enters at a velocity of 12 meters per second, pressure 1 bar, specific volume 0.5 meter cube per kilogram. Leaves at a velocity of 90 meters per second, pressure 8 bar and specific volume is 0.14 meter cube per kilogram. The increase in enthalpy of the air passing through the compressor is 150 kilojoules per kilogram and heat loss to the surrounding is 12 kilojoules per second. So, find the power required to drive the compressor, ratio of inlet to the outlet pipe diameter. So, this is from Anna University question paper November 2018. Now, given data, write down the given data. After reading the problem, write down the given data. Mass equal to 720 kilograms per hour, which is 0.2 kilograms per second. Velocity is 12 meters per second at inlet. Pressure is 1 bar at inlet. Specific volume is 0.5 meter cube per kilogram. Velocity at the outlet is 90 meters per second. Pressure at the outlet is 8 bar. Specific volume is 0.14 meter cube per kilogram. And change in enthalpy, H2 minus H1 equal to 150 kilojoules per kilogram. And heat transfer, it is 12 kilojoules per second. So, the heat is lost, it is minus value, minus of 12 kilojoules per second. And the steady flow energy equation, general form of the steady flow energy equation you have to write. And we have to simplify the general equation for this given specific condition. We are not given the Z1, Z2 value. So, the Z1, Z2 values are dropped here. So, m into v1 square minus v2 square by 2 plus h1 minus h2 plus q. So, substituting the values 0.2 into 12 square minus 90 square divided by 2 plus. So, h1 minus h2 is minus 150 kilojoules per kilogram. So, multiplying by 1000, this will be joules per kilogram minus q value is given as 12 kilojoules per second. So, this is minus 12,000. So, simplifying and calculating the value, W equal to minus of 42.8 kilojoules per second or 42.8 kilowatts. So, the negative sign implies, negative sign indicates the work is given to the compressor. So, ratio of inlet and the outlet pipe diameter. So, A1 V1 by V1 equal to A2 V2 by V2. Using this equation, we can calculate the A1 by A2 equal to capital V2 by small V2 into small V1 by capital V1. So, simplifying in terms of diameter, so D1 by D2 equal to square root of V2 by small V2 into small V1 by capital V1 equal to, substitute the numerical values here, 90 by 0.14 into 0.5 divided by 12 equal to 5.7. And this is the answer to the problem. Power output, power input to the compressor is 42.8 kilojoules per second and ratio of inlet to the outlet diameter is 5.17. And we stop here. The additional problems, few more problems are there that we will solve in the next lecture. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the notes. You can also refer to it for additional information or additional problems. And this is my address. You can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to all your queries. So, thank you for watching and we'll meet again.